What's up guys, PJ here, hope you have a wonderful day. Today I'm gonna give you some big news and big updates on the HCMC lawsuit. Before I talk about the lawsuit, be sure to subscribe, turn on the post notifications so you don't miss any videos, and let's jump right into it. If we take a quick look at the chart of HCMC, HCMC is currently at 0.0018. 5 days ago the stock was at 0.0035, so the stock has been on the downtrend this week, but it's pretty normal because the whole market was in the red on a downtrend, so pretty normal to see HCMC at 0.0018. If we look at Bar Short recommends HCMC at 80%, last week was 96%, last month 64%, they went from 96 to 80 in 1 week. If we look on stock twist, there are 75,701 people watching HCMC, so there's a big demand around HCMC. A lot of people are looking attention or paying attention to HCMC, to what's happening with the lawsuit. There are a lot of people behind HCMC, supporting HCMC, so we can only expect the price to go up once we have some great news coming. If we look for the demand on HCMC on Google Trends, we can see some big spikes. Last week we got only big spikes, and the biggest spike on Friday when the news of the lawsuit came in. So big spikes, a lot of demand, a lot of people are investing, a lot of people are holding, so only great news for us. Without waiting, let's get into the big news and big updates on HCMC. Today I wanted to get in depth on HCMC, on the lawsuit, on the motion to dismiss. A lot of people are talking about different scenarios, a lot of people are seeing things that mean nothing, a lot of people are speculating a lot, so I want to get clear on the whole lawsuit and the motion to dismiss and where we can see the lawsuit heading in the next weeks, next months, next years, so it's clear for everyone and you're up to date, because misinformation can impact the way you trade a stock, so it's good to have facts only and to have the good facts. If you just arrive and don't know what's happening with this whole situation, to make it quick, HCMC is suing Philip Morris for patent infringement for the IQOS product. The IQOS product is one of the best-selling products of Philip Morris. It was 23.8% of the revenue of 2020, which is about $1.6 billion. So there's a lot of money at stake here for HCMC. If HCMC wins the lawsuit, they can get a lot of money, a lot of new users. The IQOS had 14.6 million users. Now the latest news for HCMC is that Friday, Philip Morris filed a motion to dismiss. What does that mean? I saw a lot of people talking about different things, speculating different things. Today we're going to talk about the facts only. The facts are backed up by the YouTube channel Jawsomesauce. He helped a lot with this video, he helped a lot with the facts. So if you like the facts that I will provide, and if this video will be helpful, you can check him out, Jawsomesauce. I'll link his channel in the description. He's an awesome YouTuber, he helped me a lot to understand this whole situation and what the motion to dismiss really means and what it means for HCMC and the stock and for us investors. I have my notes here with some big important facts and big dates for this whole situation. Now the first thing to keep in mind is that a motion to dismiss is a normal thing to do. That's what we see in a lot of cases, in a lot of lawsuits. Lawyers will file a motion to dismiss, so that's perfectly normal. Nothing to be scared is for the situation, it's a normal thing to do. What's the good news for HCMC is that a motion to dismiss rarely succeeds, so that's a great news for us. So the chances for Philip Morris to be granted the motion to dismiss are very low. Great news. The first thing that will happen with a motion to dismiss is that Philip Morris has 14 days to respond. Once they have responded, Philip Morris has 14 days to respond back, so that's a total of 28 days. And after that, the judge will rule, so that will take a couple of days. So we can say that in 1 month, the motion to dismiss will be granted or denied. If the motion to dismiss gets granted, the lawsuit ends and HCMC loses, the stock price goes to the ground. If the motion to dismiss is denied, the lawsuit continues, and there's a big chance that the stock price will go up, because that will be some big news on Reddit, on Twitter, on YouTube. People will see it, they will maybe start investing again in HCMC, and we'll maybe expect a little rise in the stock price of HCMC. That's in 1 month. Now what happens when the motion to dismiss is denied? We go into pre-discovery motions. At this moment we'll also arrive at the optional mediation. That's the moment where we can see a potential settlement. So if there comes an agreement between HCMC and Philip Morris, that's the optional mediation to come to a settlement. That would be a great news for us, that they come to a settlement together. That will be the first great thing to hope. If they don't agree and there's no settlement, we go into the discovery phase. That can take 3 to 5 months. That's when they review all the documents, when they do the interrogations. So that takes between 3 to 5 months. After that time period, we enter into the required mediation. That's when people will push HCMC to come to an agreement and to settle, to find a settlement. That's a good news about that is that historically, all the lawsuits end there at the optional mediation. People find an agreement, there's a settlement, and both parts are happy in most cases. That's historically what happens during the required mediation. People come to an agreement, HCMC and Philip Morris will settle, we come to a settlement, to an agreement. So that's a great thing to expect for us. Great news can come at that moment. That will come 8 to 9 months from now. Now, the bad news is that there is no settlement at the required mediation. They don't agree, so they go to trial, to pre-motion trial and to trial. And that's where the annoying part starts, because that can take a lot of time. It's between 3 to 4 years. After the trial is the appeal, so that is really annoying. That takes a long time. At that moment, a lot of investors lose hope and they sell their shares, and we'll see stock price go to the ground. So that's a bad news and something we don't have to hope for HCMC, because the best thing we can expect is that they come into an agreement, a settlement. A great thing about the settlement is that it can happen at any time. It doesn't have to be during the optional mediation or during the required mediation. It can happen anytime from now. They can come into an agreement, a settlement on Monday, next week, next month. It doesn't have to be during the optional mediation or during the required mediation. It can happen anytime. So that's a good thing to expect and a good thing for us. If they come into an agreement and to a settlement, the lawsuit ends, everyone is happy, the stock price goes up. That will be the best thing to expect, that they come into an agreement, a settlement, and that can happen anytime. So that's a great news. We don't have to wait 3 to 5 months or 8 months. That can happen anytime. So with all this explained, the next thing to look out for is when HCMC has to respond to the motion to dismiss, and they have to respond to the motion to dismiss on March 15th. That's the 14 days period. After they have responded, Philip Morris has 14 days to respond back. That's a total of 28 days. And then the judge will rule if he grants it or denies it. Now what HCMC can do is they can respond on Monday, and then Philip Morris responds on Tuesday, and we have a response of the judge at the end of the week if he grants it or denies it. Historically, both parties take all the time necessary, so 14 days to respond for HCMC, 14 days to respond for Philip Morris, and then the judge will rule. Some people will talk about different information, some people will misinterpret it, some people will sell their shares because they think, yeah, it's getting way too long, I'm selling, I don't want to hold, I can't hold anymore. So we can maybe expect the price of HCMC to drop once again. My opinion, I'm gonna hold, I'm gonna keep on holding till the end of the lawsuit. I'm just gonna keep on holding, I'm gonna put it away and focus on other stocks, but I'm just gonna hold my shares. In my opinion, it's worthless to sell now because the motion to dismiss, it doesn't tell nothing. So I'm just gonna hold my shares, I'm gonna keep on holding and see in the next month, next 2 months, next years, what the situation is. Just gonna keep on holding. I'm gonna focus on other stocks. There are other stocks out there other than HCMC. There are other big winners that are gonna come. So I'm happy to be an investor in HCMC. I'm just gonna hold and see how this whole situation turns out. Now there's a chance that we lose all, that I lose all my money. I'm ready for that. I have other stocks, I have other investments. That's why it's important to be diversified, to have different stocks, different penny stocks, different high growth stocks. Just be diversified so that if one goes down, you don't lose all your money. That's the number one rule, be diversified. Talking about different stocks, this week is the second week of the YouTube portfolio where we invest $1,000 in one stock. I have a list of 5 different stocks, some stocks that are chosen and that ARK Invest has invested in. Those are some big 5 high growth stocks. You have the option to choose one of the 5. The one that has the most comments, I'm gonna invest $1,000 in tomorrow at the open market or during the day. So you can choose from those 5 high growth stocks. The stocks are Shopify, Twitter, Palantir, Square, and Baidu. You can choose from those 5. Comment which one you want me to invest $1,000 in. Last week, you chose Nintendo. Let's see what you choose this week. You have 5 stocks, Shopify, Palantir, Square, Baidu, Twitter. We're gonna look at the chart to see a little bit how they're doing, and you can comment which one you prefer, which one you want me to invest $1,000 in. The first stock you can choose from is Shopify. We can see here Shopify is currently at $1,280, up 3% on Friday. Nice. If you look 5 days ago, the stock was at 1,398, so lost in 1 week. That's a big part because all the whole week was in the red. 1 month ago, the stock was at 1,144, so nice growth in 1 month. 6 months ago, nice, the stock was at $1,000. 1 year ago, the stock was at 463, so the stock tripled in 1 year. Some great growth, a really beautiful chart. Shopify is a really great stock. The second one to choose from, Palantir, currently sitting at 23.90. 5 days ago, the stock was at 29, also lost because of the red days. 1 month ago, the stock was at 33. 6 months ago, the stock was at 9. So the stock doubled in 6 months. Also some nice growth, but right now it's going down. I saw that ARK Invest has bought 2 million shares on Friday. So this one is expected to go to the moon. So this is the second one. The third one to choose from, Baidu, it's currently sitting at 283. 5 days ago, the stock was at 322. 1 month ago, 241. 6 months ago, 124. So the stock doubled in 6 months. Also some nice growth. ARK Invest, Cathie Wood has also invested in that one. Fourth one on the list, Square, $230 a share. 5 days ago, the stock was at 271. 1 month, 221. 6 months, 159, also some nice growth. This one has a big potential because of all the cryptocurrency and the blockchain. So this one has a lot of potential for the future. And the last one to choose from is Twitter, currently at 77 a share. 5 days ago, the stock was at 73, 1 month ago, 52, and 6 months, 40. So almost doubled in 6 months. Also some nice growth. We can see a big spike in the last month. Some great high growth stocks, some great stocks to choose from. Tell me which one you want me to invest $1,000 in on Monday. Shopify, Baidu, Palantir, Square, or Twitter. You choose, I invest. Now talking about ARK Invest, investing in Cathie Wood. You can see on February 26, on Friday, they bought 44,000 shares of Shopify. They bought 352,000 shares of Twitter, 96,000 of Baidu, 2,497,000 shares of Palantir, and 217,000 shares of Square. They bought them all on Friday, so we're gonna invest in them on Monday. Choose one that I will invest $1,000 in. Remember that everything I said in this video is for entertainment purposes only. If you enjoy, you can leave a like, subscribe so you don't miss anything, and I'll see you in the next one.